everybody. This is Anita Saxena, editor, Aviation and Defense Universe, getting you live from DEFEXPO 2022 at Gandhi Nagar, the city of Mahatma Gandhi and his philosophy of nonviolence. And here we have a show which is absolutely defense, absolutely arms, armament and equipment. Wonderful, absolutely. This is the merger of the modern and the previous times. And here we are at a very major collaboration with our very old friend Russia, which is the Brahmos. Everybody knows Brahmos. And we have with us here Dr. Atul Rane, who's also the CEO and Managing Director of Brahmos. So welcome absolutely to KDU's chat room. And it's so wonderful, sir, that this is a show which is happening for the first time. It's being said that it's happening for the Indian industry. What is the feel that you get out of this show? We've been seeing it since the morning now. So, how do you feel about it?
The DEFEXPO, what is the other way? It's a show which we normally put on to get the foreigners in. But for once, because there are less number of foreigners, for many reasons, this has become an industry show. It's always been an industry show. It's not just DRDO and the forces. The industry has always been out. But this time the emphasis is on trying to show everyone, the industry as well as to ourselves, to show the world that how much the industry is involved in defense now. There's been a lot of difference over the years, and now's the time to showcase it to the world.
Absolutely wonderful, sir. And how has the footfall been here from Brahmos, sir, since the morning?
I haven't sat down. It's the first time I've seen thanks for coming.
Absolutely, that's wonderful. Which means that it's been a very, very busy half day which has happened. And sir, with Brahmos is a great name, and in India, the fact that it's a joint venture, a collaboration between our very old friend Russia, we always have felt that Brahmos is our own. Now sir, how do you feel that when we started with Brahmos, we started with an aim and objective in mind. After so many years,
started Brahmos in 1998, after the government agreement, the whole idea was first to develop something which is equivalent to what the world has, making it better. And that's what we always have thought, that we should always work on something which is the best. To survive in this world, in this market, that's the main thing, that you have to be one of the best, or the best. You have to be able to deliver on time, and have quality. The thing we need. Brahmos was conceived as a joint venture. We designed, developed, and then when the production started, the idea was, it was a mindset that can we work together with our partners? Because till then it was a buyer-seller, which was where we could work together. We worked out well because we had a the market, we got our orders from the armed forces, starting with the Navy, then the Army, and now the Air Force also. So we have managed to do what we wanted to do. When people ask me about this, has India gained? We have gained. Has Russia gained? They also do. So it's been a win-win situation for everyone in the world. Indigenous, I know you're going to ask me that. It's a joint venture. How can we be 100%? So we have to do business for our partners. But yes, we have seen from the current geopolitical situation in the earlier days that self-reliance is something which is important. Atul Nirbharta, which talks about the made in making India, made in India, whatever. So Brahmos had this in mind well before we started talking about Atul Nirbharta. Because we had started revolutionizing the systems. The whole ground system is developed and designed in India, so it's a good thing for us. The missile is where we are in the process of revolutionizing. We have reached 68%. We will hit about 72, maybe another couple of months. But that's it that we have planned. We are under pressure, why not 100%? Why not will do that with our next version. We are looking at something else. So we'll do that with this version, we will be stopping this.
Right, sir, and which means, if you continue with what you just said, is there a very big Indian supply chain which you have for Brahmos?
We have. I mean, this is something which, when people say industry complex, so we need to get the industry into defense. Brahmos ourselves is a very big. We have about 250 companies working for us as part of the supply chain. And below that, these are the direct supply chain companies. Below that, we have a few more companies. We work with about 450 Indian companies.
Wonderful. 450 Indian companies is a big number, sir. So, that which means that you have a very nice supply chain. Now, is that also, is that supply chain also giving a way into the Russian defense market since they are here for Brahmos? Do they get some extra business?
You see, when we started the indigenization, the processes and the materials, we had to adopt from the Russians. So many of the materials were brought from Russia as a separate thing. Now what's happened is slowly as we indigenize, their market has gone down. But now we're looking at the news. That is, already my partners from Russia are looking at, is it possible that we manufacture more? Send us the products. So we are looking the other way around.
That would be
future meal. Maybe in a year and after we should be able to do.
Wonderful. That's very, very great. And so with Brahmos, the expectation also has very categorically mean that you want a market which is outside India. So there is a spot strategy which you must be having. So tell us something about this.
As I said, when we started Brahmos, we said mind the market. And we worked hard and now made it mind the world. We did get our first export order and the world has come to the world.
Yes.
So, we are looking for more. One thing I say, when we sold to the Indian Navy and when we came to the Indian Army and the Indian Air Force, there's an unending. Once you are in, they want to keep buying. So I'm just hoping that once we are out into the market there, everyone is going to start coming to us. The Philippines themselves, I would say, might come out with I want more. There are a lot of countries already. Everyone, right since 2001, when Brahmos started going out for exhibitions, we started with the UMA, that is the Innovation Exhibition 2001. And since then, we have been there in all major exhibitions. Everyone who comes to Brahmos in those days, youth, nowadays, everyone says we are interested. We said, let's talk. We get into talks with everyone. It has turned out that the Philippines were the first to a few others. Southeast Asia, Middle East, Africa, I mean, the world is looking at us. So we don't really have to have a strategy. When you are the world's best, the world's fastest, and almost you don't have to send people.
That is a wonderful note to stop on. I think that is very great. And you've given such an important time of your day. I know it's how busy it is at the moment, and I'm sure you're waiting to carry on the day. Thank you very much, sir. Thank
it's
you so
a
much.
Pleasure.
What a lovely year. It's a great day to end our day with. It's just a wonderful day. So, and we hope, Brahmos gets more and more orders. We're just hoping that you go beyond, you go to South America, you go to Africa, you go to everywhere where there's a requirement. And also I hope we are alive to see this, that you also have, the big countries you have who are their own desire makers, they also feel that Brahmos is a better option. So you want this. It'll happen someday.